हेलो फ्रेंड्स, नाउ वी विल लर्न अ स्टीरियो केमिस्ट्री ऑफ 1,4 डायमिथिल साइक्लोहेक्सेन। सो दिस इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ 1,4 डायमिथिल साइक्लोहेक्सेन। सो दिस इज कार्बन नंबर 1, कार्बन नंबर 2, कार्बन नंबर 3 एंड कार्बन नंबर 4। सो दिस इज 1,4 डायमिथिल साइक्लोहेक्सेन। सो इन दिस केस देर आर टू मिथिल्स ग्रुप्स। सो इट मीन्स दैट either these two methyls are on the same side of the molecular plane of this cyclohexane, or it may possible that two methyls are on the opposite side of this molecular plane of the molecule. It means that dimethyl cyclohexane, that is 1,4 dimethyl cyclohexane, shows a geometrical isomerism. So one will be cis isomer and second will be trans isomer. For example, here, suppose this is axial methyl, then 1, 2, 3 and 4. At this position, this methyl may be equatorial or may be axial. So if axial is there, then this will be trans. So it means that if these methyls are on the same side of molecular plane, then this is called as cis 1,4 dimethyl cyclohexane. If these methyls are on the opposite side of the molecular plane of this molecule, then this is called as trans 1,4 dimethyl cyclohexane. Now we'll see the stereochemistry of all these cis and trans isomerism. First we'll start with the cis 1,4 dimethyl cyclohexane. For writing, you have to write this methyl first, then carbon number 1, 2, 3, carbon number 4, 5 and 6. So at this carbon number 4, cis, so both methyls are on the same side, so this will become equatorial methyl. So this form is called as axial equatorial cis 1,4 dimethyl cyclohexane. If you try to write down the ring flip structure of this cis 1,4 dimethyl cyclohexane, suppose this is the structure, this carbon number 1 and this is the carbon number 4. Carbon number 1, that is the axial methyl, so 1, 2, 3 and 4, this is the fourth carbon, this is equatorial methyl. So ring flip structure means this carbon number 1 goes down while this carbon number 4 goes up. So see clearly, this is carbon number 1 goes down while this carbon number 4th comes up. So this is the new cyclohexane chain we will get. See here now, this methyl was previously axial, now this becomes equatorial. This methyl was equatorial, now this is becomes axial. So in ring flipping, methyl groups are converted to the axial while axial groups are converted to the equatorial. Now we'll draw the structure of this molecule. So after ring flipping, this carbon will goes up and this carbon comes down. So this is carbon number 1 and this is carbon number 4. So this axial methyl is converted to the equatorial while this equatorial methyl is converted to the axial. So this is carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. This is structure number 1 and this is structure number 2. Now we will try to write down a mirror images of these structures. Mirror images of these structures. See here. So this is axial methyl. This is 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5 and 6. So 4 carbon methyl is equatorial. So this is equatorial methyl. If you try to write down a ring flip structure for this one, then what will happen? This carbon number 1 goes down and carbon number 4 goes up. So this is equatorial methyl. This is the axial methyl. So this is carbon number 1, this is 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So these are the structures, mirror images of this structure. So carbon number, this is compound number 1, this is compound number 3, that is a mirror image of this compound number first. This is compound number 2nd and this is the compound number 4, that is a mirror image of compound number 2. So in this way, these are the structures of cis-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane. Just now we have seen that cis-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane, or you can say 1,4-dimethylcyclohexane is geometrical isomerism. So this is the first geometrical isomerism, that is cis-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane. So 1,4-dimethylcyclohexane has a geometrical isomers. Now we'll see the optical isomerism. Optical isomerism of this cis-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane. Friends, optical isomerism means their mirror images are non-superimposable. The stereoisomers whose mirror images are non-superimposable. See here, compound number 1 and compound number 3 are the mirror images. If you see this compound number 3, if you rotate this compound number 3 with just 180s, then this methyl will be this methyl and this methyl will be this methyl. So you can say that compound number 1 and compound number 3 are superimposable mirror images. These are the superimposable mirror images. So that makes compound number 1 and compound number 3 are the same and optically inactive compounds. So compound number 1 and compound number 3 are optically inactive. Similar case for this one also, compound number 2 and compound number 4. If you just rotate this molecule with 180, so you can easily see this is compound becomes this compound. So both compounds are same, just you have to rotate this molecule with 180 degrees. So it means that these two molecules, that is two compound and compound number 4, are a superimposable mirror images. That makes compound number 2 and compound number 4 are optically inactive. It means that compound number 1, 2, 3, 4 all are, that is cis-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane, are optically inactive. Are optically inactive. So cis-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane, that isomer, is optically inactive. Secondly, we will see this compound. Now suppose this is compound number 1. Compound number 1, this is the carbon number 1, axial methyl, and this is the carbon number 4, equatorial methyl. If you look this compound in this way, you can easily see that this molecule possesses a plane of symmetry. If molecule possesses a plane of symmetry, plane is passing through carbon number 1 and carbon number 4, this methyl as well as this methyl. So compound is plane is passing through this carbon number 1 and carbon number 4 and both methyls. So this molecule has a plane of symmetry, and because of that one, this molecule becomes optically inactive. So isomer cis-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane is optically inactive. There are two reasons. First one is plane of symmetry. This plane is passing through carbon number 1 and carbon number 4. Second reason, their mirror images are superimposable. Mirror images are superimposable. So because of these reasons, cis-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane, that is axial equatorial form, are optically inactive. Now we will learn relative potential energies of these molecules. Relative potential energy of this molecule. In this molecules, all four molecules contains one methyl is axial and one methyl is equatorial. Suppose one methyl is axial. So if methyl is axial, these methyls are axial, so it shows 1,3 diaxial interactions with these axial hydrogens. This shows 1,3 diaxial interactions with this hydrogen. If there is a 1,3 diaxial interaction, then energy of the molecule rises with 0.9 kilocalorie per mole. As there are two 1,3 diaxial interactions, energy of the molecule rises with 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. So axial methyl, there are two 1,3 diaxial interactions. So 2 × 1,3 diaxial interaction energy rises with 0.9 kilocalorie per mole. So total energy of the molecule rises around 1.8 kilocalorie per mole if one methyl is axial. Now this methyl is equatorial. If methyl is equatorial, there is no any torsional strain, no any 1,3 diaxial interaction, as well as butane-Gotch interaction. So if methyl is axial, there will be no change in relative potential energy of the molecule. There is no change in relative potential energy of the molecule. So total energy of the molecule is equal to, this is 1.8 plus 0.0 is equal to 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. So energy of the molecule rises from 0.0 to 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. So energy of this form, that is axial equatorial, that is 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. As the energy of the molecule rises, molecule becomes unstable. So in this way, we have learned that geometrical isomerism, optical isomerism, and relative potential energies of cis-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane, that is axial equatorial form. Now we will learn the stereochemistry of trans-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane. Friends, now we will learn the stereochemistry of trans-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane. While writing the structure, this methyl you have to write first. Then writing all the structures will be easier. This can be axial or equatorial, you can write anything, but write this methyl as a first. Now fourth carbon, 1, 2, 3, and 4, this is the fourth carbon. So we have to write a methyl, second methyl. So this is trans. Trans means both methyls are on the opposite side of the carbon of the molecular plane of this cyclohexane. If this methyl is upside, second methyl should be downside, that becomes axial. So this form is called as axial form. This methyl, this form is called as axial form. Now ring flip structure. So as we know that axial becomes equatorial, so this axial also becomes equatorial. So axial form is converted to the equatorial form. So there are two forms for this trans-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane, that is axial and equatorial. Now we'll write the mirror images of this compound. This methyl is over here, this methyl is over here for the fourth carbon. For this one, this methyl mirror images, this methyl fourth carbon, so this is the fourth carbon equatorial methyl. So this is the mirror image of compound number 2. So all these structures are trans 1,4-dimethyl cyclohexane. Structure number 1 and structure number 3 are the mirror images, that is axial, 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 axial. So this is axial, axial form. While structure number 2 and structure number 4 are equatorial, 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 equatorial. So this is equatorial, equatorial form. So trans 1,4-dimethyl cyclohexane is observed into two forms, that is axial, axial and equatorial, equatorial. Hello friends, suppose this is structure number 1, this is that molecule, this carbon number 1 axial methyl, this is carbon number 4 axial methyl. Now we will see the ring flip structure. Ring flip means this carbon number 1 comes down and this carbon number 4 goes up. See, green, this is the axial methyl, this is the red axial methyl and this is the green axial methyl. Now see, this is carbon number 1, I am making it down, and this is the carbon number 4, I am making it up. Now you can easily see that another form of this molecule. So this carbon number 1 red methyl becomes equatorial and this is the carbon number 4 green methyl becomes equatorial. So in ring flip structure, as we know that axial groups are converted to the equatorial and equatorial groups are converted to the axial groups. These are the mirror images. Now as we know that geometrical isomerism, so yes, 1,4-dimethyl cyclohexane has a geometrical isomer and we are studying now trans isomer. Next is optical isomerism. Optical isomerism. Friends, this compound, that is trans 1,4-dimethyl cyclohexane, is optically active or inactive, that we will learn. First, suppose this is the mirror images of this compound. 1 and 3 are the mirror images. Now if you rotate this molecule, see this axial methyl is this side. If you rotate this molecule with 180s, then this is the axial methyl. It means that these are the same structure, just if you rotate then you will get the same structure. It means that these are the superimposable mirror images. These are the superimposable mirror images. If you look at this structure, this is the first carbon axial methyl, this is the fourth carbon axial methyl. If you look like this, if you understand that this molecule possesses a plane of symmetry. The plane is passing through carbon number 1 and carbon number 4. Plane is passing through carbon number 1 and carbon number 4. This molecule is symmetrical. So, as a molecule possesses a plane of symmetry, that molecule becomes mesocompound and becomes optically inactive. So, it has a plane of symmetry. And plane is passing through carbon number 1 and carbon number 4, making it optically inactive. Optically inactive. Similarly, if this is a compound number 2, this is carbon number 1, axial methyl, this is carbon number 4, carbon number 1, equatorial methyl, carbon number 4, equatorial methyl. If you look this molecule in this way, then this also possesses a plane of symmetry passing through carbon number 1 and carbon number 4. Similarly, if this is a compound, if you rotate this compound, this is compound number 2, axial methyl and axial methyl, equatorial methyl and equatorial methyl. If you rotate this molecule without changing anything, then you can see easily these two molecules are same. That means these are the superimposable mirror images, and as well as it contains a plane of symmetry passing through carbon number 1 and carbon number 4. That makes compound number 1, 2, 3 and 4 all are optically inactive compound. So in this way you conclude that either cis or trans 1,4-dimethyl cyclohexane are optically inactive compounds. Now we'll see the relative energies of trans-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane one by one. First we'll see the axyl-axyl, then we'll see the for equatorial-equatorial. Relative energies of the molecule. Suppose we will see for axial first. So just now in last slides we have seen that if there is an axial methyl, then it shows a 2-1-3 diaxial interactions with these axial hydrogens. So energy of the molecule rises 1.8 kilocalorie per mole if one methyl is axial. In this molecule there are two methyls are axial, so it shows total 4-1-3 diaxial interactions, two for this methyl and two for this methyl. So there are total 4-1-3 diaxial interaction. So 4 into, because of this 1-3 diaxial interaction, energy rises around 0.9 kilocalorie per mole. So total energy of this axyl-axyl methyl rises around 3.6 kilocalorie per mole. So if both methyls are axial, then energy rises around 3.6 kilocalorie per mole. If these methyls are equatorial-equatorial. Suppose this is the molecule. If this group is equatorial, it don't show any 1,3 diaxial interaction or butane-Gotch interaction or any torsional strain. So if methyl group is equatorial, there is no change in energy. This is for one methyl. Second, this is also equatorial, so there is also no change in energy. So energy of the molecule becomes 0.0 kilocalorie per mole. So energy of axyl-axyl form is 3.6 kilocalorie per mole, while if equatorial-equatorial, energy is 0.0 kilocalorie per mole. Just in last video we have seen that, in just last slide we have seen that axial equatorial, the energy rises around 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. Now let's see the relative stability of these isomers. As we know that if the energy of the molecule rises, molecule becomes unstable. If energy is less, molecule is stable. So there are three isomers, we'll write those: axial-axial, axial-equatorial and equatorial-equatorial. Energies of this molecule is axial-axial 3.6, 1.8 and 0.0. As we know that the energy of the molecule rises, molecule becomes unstable. If energy of the molecule decreases, molecule becomes stable. So the stability of this molecule is in this manner: equatorial-equatorial forms are more stable than axial-equatorial, than axial-axial. So this is the stability order for the 1,4 dimethyl cyclohexane isomers. So there are three isomers, one is axial-axial, one is axial-equatorial, one is equatorial-equatorial. Cis and trans are the geometrical isomerism. The most stable isomer of 1,4-dimethylcyclohexane is equatorial-equatorial form. The relative potential energy is 0.0, and most unstable form of 1,4-dimethylcyclohexane is axial-axial, that energy rises around 3.6 kilocalorie per mole. So in this way we have learned all the isomers of डाई सब्स्टिट्यूटेड, दैट इज डाइमिथिल साइक्लोहेक्सेन. देयर ज्योमेट्रिकल आइसोमेरिज्म, ऑप्टिकल आइसोमेरिज्म, रिलेटिव एनर्जीज एंड रिलेटिव स्टेबिलिटीज. थैंक यू फ्रेंड्स.